Time. to remisi oluwa iwo lo mo be ibi to remisi Ogo re fun aye eh
Ebi lẹ́rìí kan, ebi lẹ́rìí.
Lost photo by you.
Thank you. pa ti won fun iranse olorun yen pa ti won fun iranse olorun yen dada. Now without wasting time we want to usher in the man of God an astute preacher of the word of God and the prophet of this generation, Pastor Toby Thompson. You want shame for you? And she, Bibeli, is in Psalm 75. Ezekepha. 75, verse 6. Psalm. Kiluka, Taluambe. Psalm 75, verse 6. Oro Olorun wi pe mo fe ke mo igbega ta n soro nipa eyi ki ti la orun wa
tabi ni iwo orun be ni ki se lati gusu wa sugbo Olorun ni onidajo o so kakale o si gbe elomiran leke
a ma so elomiran kale a de ma gbe elomiran soke anu Olorun le da finga anu Olorun le da finga Rubeni okunrin to ga Joseph okunrin to kere Joseph Waloke Ruben Wanile Anu Olorun le da finga
Baye ba o jaye Oluwa wa sile Baye ba o jaye Oluwa wa sile Je ka fugu fun oba to wa sile
Let us celebrate the man of God, Pastor, Prophet Toby Thompson. God bless you, sir.
Jesus very, very well. Clap for Jesus. Don't clap for me, clap for Jesus. Hebrews chapter 8, 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That means he has capacity over my yesterday. I have committed error in the past. That has nothing to do with my today. As long as Jesus is concerned, he has capacity over my yesterday, he's in control of my today, and he has gotten to my tomorrow. He knows what is there in my tomorrow. That is the definition of that place, that Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. I have one authority tonight, and that authority is in Christ Jesus. The word of God said to me, he said he has given me a name that is above every other name. As long as I am connected to that name, that in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, everything on earth, everything on the net, and everything in the highest, they must bow to Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus now. Thank you, Lord. Because you are God and you are God alone forever. We don't take this lightly and we don't don't take it for granted. I take special time to celebrate the grace of God upon Remelekwemos International Gospel Ministry. We thank God. Put your hands together for Jesus. We thank God for what God has been doing. It can just be only Jesus. Remelekun Amos International Gospel Ministry. 20 good years of putting ourselves together. No quarrel for 20 years. 20 years of God's sustenance. 20 years of God leading. Just young people gather themselves together in the middle of chaos and they move ahead. First album in the middle of chaos. I say, God, you are the one leading. Are you sure of follows? And then, God did not leave this team for once. 20 good years of God's backing. 20 years of God's sustenance. 20 years of God's expansion. The Lord is expanding the team. 20 good years. 20 years. God keep enlarging the team. Band members keep expanding. The coast keep expanding. From coast to coast, it can only be Jesus. What about sustenance? 20 years. God sustained this group. 20 good years. Sustenance. 20 years. It can only be Jesus. We will hear more next month. Next month is going to be a special day. The Lord will keep us. The grace that has been following us from onset, that grace will not depart from us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you want to say amen, you say with boldness. Because amen is a symbol of authority. And we pray for everybody across this platform tonight. You are not on this platform by accident. You are not on this platform by mistake. Because our God does not perform mistake. Mistake is not in his characteristics. So if anybody is connected to this platform tonight, it is because God has arranged you for elevation. And I'll pray for somebody today. From this moment onward, elevation, your lineage has not entered before. From tonight, the door is open to your life.
Amen.
Amen is a symbol of authority. Amen means what they said is for me. Amen is a sign of clearance. It's a clearance. Amen is an approval that the prayer belongs to me. And I pray for somebody here and everybody who is attached to this platform tonight, where you have been suffering elevation in the past, that you have been suffering elevation. From tonight, the door elevation is open to your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Once again, put your hands together for the grace that has been keeping us for these 20 good years. What a wonderful God we are serving. I especially celebrate Lake Remelekwemos. You have been wonderful. Every time I refer to him as a speed racer, not a speed breaker, when the mantle fall upon him, he does not keep the tempo. There's one thing they call sustenance, sustainability. Let's just go on the temple we have received. Sustainability. This is not sustainability. He raised the bar beyond every limit doubt, every reasonable doubt. He raised the bar. Faces you see in the band are constant faces for 20 good years. Faces you see in the band, constant faces for 2 years, 20 good years. Somebody once said, leadership simply means you are leading while people are following you. If you say you are a leader and you are leading and nobody is following you, you are not leading, you are only walking. You are just only taking a walk. You are leading, nobody is following you, you are not leading, you are just only walking. Put your hands together for Jesus. I celebrate the grace of God upon your life. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will multiply you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Fresh fire from heaven shall keep falling upon you.
Amen.
There will be new every morning. I pray that same covenant that is in the power of God, that is renewing the grace every morning, That covenant shall keep working for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Help me to put you all together for him once again. And most importantly, every crew behind this, those who are within the multimedia, those who are within the sound, we cannot be heard if your IQ is not put into place. So we also celebrate the grace of God upon your life, our honorable and great sound engineers, and those who are within the multimedia, we say thank you. Please help me to put your hands together, and I pray by the grace of God, Christ, who is the seat of all knowledge, we keep on leading you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And anywhere you are, Ramilek Wemos, we raise the bar. We celebrate the grace upon your lifetime. We celebrate the grace upon the calling of God that you have laid the legacy on ground, and we keep on following. We thank God for testimonies. We thank God for time, life spent. We thank God for all songs you have written in your lifetime. Their messages are raw. You receive from God in a time to come like this. This era has not come at all. God has called Emile Guemos to sit, and he told him, write songs. A generation coming. 2000 has not come. He has written about Iriria Yenimoso. 2020 hasn't come. He has written so many songs that are fulfilling prophecy now. So we celebrate the lifetime of a great icon. We celebrate the call of a great man of God that refuses to die, refuses to rest, and still keep on speaking. Put your hands together for Jesus. Anywhere you are now, the grace of God will celebrate it, and the glory of God shall keep on radiating in the heavens. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every member standing tonight, I celebrate the grace of God upon your life. Ministers of God that has ministered, Aisholu Obebe, Evangelist Sunday, the Lord will bless you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hey, this guy said this month is a month of elevation. Elevation. I think this is your boy. I have told him he has entered into the class of the prophets, but he doesn't want to believe. Sent her into the class of the prophets, but he doesn't want to believe. All right, when we talk about elevation, Jesus Christ, somebody who can say amen.
Amen.
Tonight, the Lord will elevate you.
Amen.
Your amen is good. Amen. It's good. It's not good enough. The Lord will elevate you.
Amen.
If there's any authority anywhere that has capacity to tame your elevation, Tabari agbara, Tony agbara, abi eni akata bi ninu obirin, Tony agbara lati da igbega yi duro lati akoko yi lo, orun agbe won lejo se. We mean it here tonight. Elevation, 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 elevation. He spoke about Psalm 79 the other time, Psalm 75, Psalm 75, Psalm 75. I am still going to keep praying. By the grace of God, every evil demon that they are sending to tame your elevation, elevation equals to promotion. Every evil demon that they are sending in your dreams to tame your elevation, to tame down your promotion, by the reason of your louder amen this night, Holy God, every demon on assignment against your elevation, tonight the Lord answered them by fire.
Amen.
I didn't hear your amen. Every demon that has capacity, let me tell you this. Look, in the physical world, there's what they call distance. 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 I don't know Yoruba for distance. In the physical world where we are, there's distance. But in the spiritual world, there's no distance. They can be here and tame somebody in America within the spiritual world because it doesn't have distance. It only works within the space of the air. So I now pray, anywhere you might be all over the world, that your life has been suffering elevation, from tonight, the Lord step into your case.
Amen.
Very good. The Lord step into your case.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I have a clear evidence in the scripture. In the book of Esther, Mordecai is supposed, Mordecai deserved, Mordecai has worked. By the way, let me tell you, look, elevation has criteria. Elevation has timing. Elevation has criteria. There is criteria for elevation. There is timing for elevation. There's criteria for elevation. There's timing for elevation. But above all, God is in charge of every elevation. And I'll pray for you tonight. What will please God to release your elevation today? You step into it in Jesus' name. Oh, Toma, she. Toma, Muki, or Union, Tai, Begare. Ah, Idi Rose. Palabosa. Oh, Toma, she. Toma, Jackie, or Union, Tai, Begare. Loni, Loro, God, Jesus, Obre, said Tawale. I didn't hear you, Obre, said Tawale. In the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 75. Let's hear the condition. That is where he stopped, and that is where I'm going to start. Don't sleep this time. Don't sleep. We are going to run very quickly with Holy Ghost fire. Yes, Kilo Sonibe. What does he say? Yes. 75 verse 6. Somebody should go and check the book of 1 Peter, chapter 5. 6 and 7. Yes! Psalm 75. I want somebody to quickly run also in English version. Igbega koti ila oluwa. Yes! Beni ki se lati gusu wa. Oh my God. But God! Is in charge of promotion. But God is in charge of promotion. God is the custodian of promotion. And I'll pray for somebody this night. Anywhere you might be all over the world, that your life has been suffering elevation in the past, by the reason of your shouting amen, typing amen, sharing amen, this moment, your elevation has come.
Amen.
God is the custodian. That means you cannot be elevated except it is approved by God. Now, he lower one and he elevates. So, he is the custodian. He is in charge of elevation. But I told you, I said there's criteria to elevation. Oh my God. And then there's time to elevation. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. If you are there, you can quickly speed up. Peter explained to us. Are you there? Peter explained to us about what we should do. Conditions surrounding elevation. Hey, I told you. I said there is criteria to elevation. God is not a waster. I want it in English version, particularly King James. Right? You can read. Humble. I told you there's criteria to elevation. Humble yourself under the arms.
The mighty hand of God.
Oh, the mighty arms of God.
That he may exalt you in due time.
That in due time. He may lift you up. Lower yourself under the training of God's mighty hand. That's criteria. And I'll pray for somebody this night. I said, every area of your life that has been suffering elevation, tonight you march into it.
Amen.
Elevation is when a man rises from an old seat to a higher one.
position to a higher position. Elevation is all time a new position. You've not experienced it before. You've not seen it before. Your lineage has not entered into this before. That is elevation. And we can see series of elevation in the scripture. But I pray tonight, the end of every elevation is thanksgiving. There's somebody here today. Thanksgiving just resume work in your life. I said thanksgiving just resume work in your life. Elevation is shifting somebody from one regular position to a higher position. And I pray for somebody today. This position you are old enough in that position. This position you are staying, this situation you are occupying, this position you are occupying, you stay long there. From now, the Lord will begin to elevate you. It is the change from one common situation to an uncommon situation. Change from a common situation, a position we've known you with before, and just of a sudden, scenario changes, situation changes. Every outstanding performance can be traced to understanding. Every outstanding performance can be traced to understanding. If you don't understand, you cannot perform better. You can only perform better when you have gained understanding. So if you see anybody that have an outstanding performance, the first thing is that they have understanding. And I'll tell you today, it is very important you wait under the training arm of God. That waiting is what is cast in this generation. This generation don't like to wait. We want elevation, but we don't want to wait. Waiting is part of the criteria for being elevated. Waiting, 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 waiting. Elevation has to do with what has been deposited in you. What God has given you, you need to put it to work. Can I tell you this very quickly? Very quickly. Can I tell you this? Not in the front. Not in the front of Pharaoh. That was not the first place Joseph interpreted dream. If you understand Jesus, clap your hands together for Jesus. Let me quickly pray for you from there. Every evil bird, they are sending on the entrance of your elevation. That bird die by fire right now.
Amen.
Am I speaking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
Not the first time. That is not the first time Joseph is going to be interpreting dreams. He has first interpreted dream for the butler. He has first interpreted dream before, not the first time. He waited. The first time he interpreted dream, nobody remembered him. No elevation. What does that mean? That is why 1 Thessalonians 5:17, he told her, he said, pray without ceasing. Some of you, you only pray when challenges come. You want the magic to happen. It's a lie. Not the first time. It was not in the presence of Pharaoh that Joseph first interpreted a dream. He has interpreted a dream that does not bring elevation. That was why they said a regular practice. Regular. Regular practice makes what? It makes perfect. When you keep calm under the leading of the Holy Spirit, keep on doing what you are supposed to do. As time goes on, it is that same thing you will do that elevation will spring up. And I pray for somebody today. From now on, heaven remember your name.
Hey,
Holy Shedubel, heaven remember your name. Any area of your life that you have been suffering, elevation in the past, every area of your life that you are due to be elevated, from today, the Lord. never step into your case. Hey. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hey. Look, you must learn a lot of things as we go. Many people want elevation. They want to come into a new position. And they don't want to go out through the rudiments. If you gain power without knowledge first, you are going to cause damage. Every power without training, without knowledge, is going to be a waste. Go waste. Who trained Samson? Who trained Samson? He received elevation by prophecy from birth. Nobody tutored him. He was not tutored by anybody. He was not mentored by anybody. And he led the land of Israel for 20 years. What I termed as monopoly of power. He was in charge of power for 20 years. He will carry the anointing of God. And he will go and sit down with Philistine and begin to gamble. I pray today, you will not waste the grace of God upon your life. Amen. I didn't hear your amen. You will not waste the grace of God upon your life. Nobody tutored him. He was not led by anybody. But he was in custodian of power. You can imagine a great man of God carrying all the anointing. He went to the land of Philistine to go and play gamble. By the time they insulted him there, he began to fight with them. He dabbled into different kind of women. By the time they turned him down, the anointing he's supposed to use in delivering Israel, he used the anointing to go and remove gates. Power without being under the arm of God. It's going to be a terrible waste. I pray you will not be a waste.
Amen.
The month of October is your month of elevation. I pray for you today. You are rising into a new position.
Amen.
When Joseph stand before King Pharaoh, he interpreted the dream and he was elevated. I told you, that was not the first time he interpreted a dream. So if you have done something before and it does not bring reward, don't quit. You have done it before. Nobody sees you. Don't quit. After all, he told Butler the conditions surrounding his dream. But he was forgotten because 1 John, 1 Peter 5, 6, and 7 has told us that there's a time for elevation. So when that time comes, if you are not qualified, you will fall into the category of Samson. And God is not a waster. So he won't waste anointing anymore. I pray for you today. From this morning, you enter into your elevation.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Saul the king, he encountered Samuel. Because the animal of his father lost. And he made himself available to go and search for it. If you want God to elevate you, please make yourself available for difficult tasks. When you want God to lift you up, always make yourself available for tasks that are difficult. The moment they say this work is difficult, hey, you will just see people, they just swallow their head. And the next day, they come to the altar of God, they say, Oluwagbemiga, Oluwagbemiga, Oluwagbemiga. But in the contrary, you don't like to make yourself available for the difficult task. Eron baba Saul Kish lo son. Saul Eron iwa lowa. Let's check. 1 Samuel chapter 9. 1 Samuel chapter 9, please turn over to it. 1 Samuel chapter 9 from verse 1 to 4. 1 Samuel chapter 9 verse 1 to 4. Then check for English. Ka Kish.
Omo Abeli. Omo Sesori. Omo Bekorati.
Yes.
Omo Afia.
Ka.
Omo Benjamini. Arakunrin alagbara.
Ka.
O si ni omokunrin kan.
Yes.
Omo oruko re ni Saul.
Saul.
Omokunrin ti o yan.
O yan.
Ti o si se arewa.
O se arewa.
Ko si si eni ti o dara ju lo.
Ko si eni to dara ju lo. Look at the attributes surrounding Saul is enough for him not to go and look for any animal. He's handsome. He's good looking. He's tall. But in respect of this attribute, he makes himself available for the difficult task. They are looking for animal that is lost. My brother, he crossed almost about four nations. Four nations. You read further. He's taller than anybody. Now, first, he entered into the land of Ephraim. And he goes across the land of Ephraim. He did not see the goat. He didn't see the sheep. He did not return back home. Please make yourself available for the difficult task. When you hear the task are strong, let me tell you, lion share is only meant for those who have a lion heart. Oh my God. Oh my God. Five good nations. Difficult task. He make himself available. And I'll pray for you today. The strength, the power to break across difficult tasks with ease, the Lord will reveal it to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So when Saul made himself available for difficult tasks, the Lord elevated him. His lineage was not in the midst of the prophets. But that day, God appointed Saul to become the first king over Israel. Why? He made himself available for difficult tasks. I was listening over the weekend. Pastor Matthew Oshimolowo, he was coming from Lagos to minister at the Redemption Camp. And then there was traffic for almost about 3.5 hours. And it was getting closer for the time for him to minister. He had to get down inside his beautiful car. And he took Okada. From Mountain of Fire Gate, he took Okada to Redemption Camp. And he left his car inside the traffic. Because the task has become difficult, there's no reason to give excuse to back out. You need elevation. Make yourself available for the difficult task. I pray for somebody today. Okun atagbara lati Oruwa loruko Jesu loni oruyan da faye re
ah Jesus
ami re da ko da to oruyan da faye re I send a double barrel of fire to the camp of your enemy. Every power that is taming your progress, that is taming your elevation, from today the Lord answered them by fire.
Amen.
Moses was elevated. But he got his own elevation by being diligent at work. He was taking care of another man's sheep. And from there, he entered into Horeb, the mountain of the Lord. Exodus 3. Because he made taking care of other people's business be his own business, he entered into elevation of God. Exodus 3, from verse 1 to 4. Exodus 3, verse 1 to 4. Exodus 3, 10 to 14. Exodus 3, very quickly. You can see, he's not even the owner of the flocks. Look at how God promoted him. He's not the owner of the flocks. He entered into elevation by being diligent. It's not an immelelized person. Yes. Yes. He took care of the ships, the floods. They trusted him. They followed him. And he leaded them to Mount Horeb. And when they got to Horeb, they discovered that the bush was burning and it was not consumed. I pray for somebody today. Your life is a signs and wonder. From today, you share me signs and wonders. They start working in your life today.
Amen.
I don't know the area of your life that you have been suffering before. Tabari gbogbo igbele aye yin bi ti e tin suffer latẹyin wa. Tabari igbele aye yin bi ti e de duro bayi to je pe igbega wa je ijiya fun yin. Latoni Olorun to ni igbega ni ikawo ti kala e lo ni agbe yin lori soke. That o toju agbo arun Jethro o wonu ibi ti papa tin jo.
O si de orebu.
O de orebu.
Oke Olorun.
Awon agutan de tele.
Angel Olorun si farahan.
O farahan.
Ninu owo ina lati inu arin igbe.
Ka.
O si wo.
Ka.
Si kiyesi. Ina njo igbe. Igbe ko si run.
I pray for your handwork today. Mo gbadura fun ise owo yin loni. Ta ba ri eyin to ye pe o ye ki ise owo yin ti gba igbega. Sugbon to wa nra ni oju kan. Lato ni loruko Jesu orun gbe ise yin soke. Anywhere you might have been connected to this platform all over the world, and your work has been suffering, struggling, from today there's going to be a divine elevation for you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He was taking care of other man's business, and from there he entered into the mountain of the Lord. And the Lord said to Moses in verse 10, and the Lord said to him, Moses, I have an assignment for you. You enter into my promotion today. Yes, verse 10.
Torina. Why is this?
There's somebody online as we speak now. You deserve promotion for the last 2 years. And one power has just been denying you. There's going to be a shift today that is going to bring a lift. I pray for you that you are online presently now and your life has been suffering elevation for the last 2 years. From today, the Lord will lift you higher.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Move ahead to verse 14. 10 to 14. Ka kilo so sibe.
Awon mo Israeli. Lati Egypt jade wa.
Ka.
Mo si wu si wi fun Olorun pe. Sale emi.
Who am I?
Se mi o fi so Pharaoh lo.
That I will go to Pharaoh.
Ati ti emi o fi le mu awon mo Israeli jade lati
Egypt wa. Who am I? Because he's diligent in another man's business. There was an appointment for him in high places. Any can wa ni bi loni mo ni ipele ti aye re nilo lati de ibi giga loni loruko Jesu orun aran ewo ibe lo.
Amen.
Ka swaju
o si wi pe ni toto
toto
emi o wa pelu re.
I am with you. Ha ka
eyi si ni yo se ami fun o pe
there's going to be a sign.
Emi lo ran o.
I don't pray for somebody today. Your life has been suffering the attention of God before. Your business has been suffering the attention of God. But by the reason of your faith and louder amen, by the typing of your amen, from today, God be with you.
Amen.
Nigba ti wo ba mu awon eniyan na lati Egypt jade wa.
Ka.
Eyin o si Olorun lori oke yi.
Okay, wait. Moses took care of another man's business. He traveled with ships and ships men. They all followed him. The ships knew him. They know. They trust Moses. Moses took them on a trip and they followed Moses. Not until they all entered into Horeb. I pray for you. Ati wo, ati gbogbo nkan to ni, both you and everything you have today, you enter into the blessing of the Lord.
Amen.
I mean, you enter into the blessing of the
Amen.
Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Never forget where we first read in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 6. It told us that we should stay under the mighty arm of God for some time. Now, anything you are doing, keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. When David featured in the presence of Saul, the king, he brought out a testimony. He said, this is not my first time of engaging to before. In fact, the battle is battle of animal. Wild animal that have sense, no sense of belonging. He said, I fought with a bear, I destroyed bear. I fought with a lion, I destroyed lion. This Goliath will be like one of them. You have been doing it, there's no recognition. Ojo to ba buarija, cause any to recognize here, no elevation. Ojo to ba bo kiniu, cause see anybody to funi elevation. But because he is consistent, he keeps doing it. Sometimes you want to be there. Another day you walk away by his time. Hey, I pity you. The day God is going to open the door of elevation, I pray you will not be missing on that day. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He stood before Saul and he told Saul, let me go and meet this man. And by the time he stepped in battle with Philistine, there's a clear indication that he has been doing it before. And I pray for somebody here. What you have been doing in the hidden that does not catch attention, from this night, henceforth, or morning, or afternoon, wherever the case might be applicable to you, that same thing you are doing today, it will catch a global attention.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can I quickly tell you this? Facebook is not an industry. Facebook is not an industry. It's one of the richest companies in the world. It's not an industry. They didn't have pipes like refinery. But they have one of the largest GDP in the world. Google, they don't have industry. It's not that you go there, oh, they have a pipe, lana, be refinery, turn it mole. No. It shows that God can just trigger some idea on your head. And you enter into elevation. And I pray for somebody today. Hey! Arati ayem wati wati ni. Ni ararere kaya barara koba. Lati o ni ilo. Oro anyo dare sinu ayere.
It's
God that does new things every day. New songs are singing the key of the Lord. I usually hear my beloved choristers, minstrel of God. They used to sing fantastically. But one day the Lord opened my eyes to one of their lyrics. All of them. It is true. Maybe let's put this straight today. It is true that the angels are singing. It is true that the angels are praising God. Best of God's handwork. He created everything by mere word. But when it came to me, he created me by putting his work, his hand to work. Then when I failed, during the time of my father Adam, and I crushed God's to come and die for me. Die for Nekaramile Kwemos. Die for Natambase. Die for Tote Alabi. And then when they were singing, they said, God, the angels are there to sing for you. You lie. The song that interests God is not the songs of the angel. It is the song of he that he created. He doesn't die for the angel. The song of Remile Kwemos is precious in the ears of God than that of angels. It's a discussion for another day. And I pray for you today. Lati oni yi lo. Owo nu igbegaye re lo. Hey, arati araye nwa. The wonder they are searching for. The wonder they are looking for. From today, the Lord release it into your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for you from today. I said elevation is a higher post, not a wider. It's a higher post. Elevation requires you to step up. You have to come up. If you are elevated on merit, you are elevated without meeting up with the criteria, you will mess up. Big time. Oh, we can see there in the scripture the parables of the talent. When the master was going, he gave one talent. He gave one two. He gave one five. He promoted them with the talent. He said, go and work. But one just decided that I cannot do anything with this one talent. He kept the talent under the ground. The one with two, the moment he received two, hey, make you laugh for me. He ran. And Bible said at the end, there was an account for him that with the two they gave it to him, he gained another two. The one that collected five, the moment they gave him five, hey, he ran to work with five. I pray for you today. Gbogbo eyin ti se yin suffer. Ti aye de se owo yin mole. In the spiritual realm, there's no distance. Won le pido fun yan ni Nigeria ko de mu yan America. It is possible. I'm privileged that this generation to pray a lot of people, pray for a lot of people, particularly in the US, where dollar is flowing. And somebody will say, I'm just walking. By the time the money touches my hand, in a few or 3 days, the money is gone. There's no distance between the spiritual realm. I travel all the way from Lagos to get here. In the spiritual realm, it's not so. It's not so. In the twinkle of an eye, they will be here and then you are there. And I pray for any one of you here. And everyone that is on the line as we speak now on this platform today, that your work has been suffering. Serious suffering of elevation. Let your knee, Lord, on what Jack Bobo Shaka Shaka told there. Say your knee. Then can I tell you, no enemy has capacity to stop your elevation. The only one that can stop the elevation is you. Amen. He tried all possible best to tame down Mordecai. Even when Mordecai told the king that two people want to kill you, instead of Mordecai to be decorated, his elevation was converted to that of Haman. There's no problem about that. That's why I tell you, keep on doing what you're supposed to do. Don't shemele, don't dodge. Because the day the helper is going to come to elevate you, if you are not at your duty post that day, that post will not be vacant. They will give you to somebody that is already readily available. Let me tell you today, for Joseph to interpret the dream of a king, what he's supposed to gain is amnesty. What he's supposed to get is freedom. What he's supposed to get is like you are now free to go back home. I don't know the time they use for it. That is what he got. He could have gotten a license to be out of slavery and then enter into his father's house like he desires. But the king said no. Today, protocols will be turned upside down. I'm not praying for somebody here. From this night or morning or afternoon, as the case might be where you are, from now on, the table will turn in your favor. That you have been struggling before. I know that there's definition between labor and favor. human effort towards production process. Favor is the free and internal will of God just to demonstrate his loving kindness on certain people. From the book of labor, anywhere your name sound, from this moment onward, henceforth, the favor of God will speak for you.
Amen.
I didn't hear you. The favor of God will speak for
Amen.
You. There's one man in the scripture. There's one man in the Bible. When the elevation comes for him, he does not even have two legs. I am coming. He does not even have two legs. That means your state, right? Your statue has nothing to do with your elevation. When I check properly in the scripture, when Mephibosheth got to the presence of the king, he fell down and worshiped. And then the Lord told me that is what he has been doing in the back room. He's a worshiper in the back room. When the king said, come forward, and he stand before the king, immediately he threw away his crutches and he just go down. Bah! And he begin to worship. He worship. He worship. The Lord said, that is what he has been doing in the back room. So that same thing brought him to the presence of the king. And the king said, Mephibosheth, from today and throughout your life, you will eat with me on this table. Everything that belongs to your father Jonathan, everything that, by the way, Jonathan is a big estate. He's the head of the defense, right? He's the head of the defense in the region of Saul. So he's a big estate. But that day, when that promotion came, that elevation came for Mephibosheth, that does not have two legs, double came upon him. The king said, what belongs to your father, Jonathan, will return to you. Then there's another bigger estate. That is the estate of your grandfather, Saul. He said, we'll return it back to you. And then the king now faced the man that has been in custody for many years. Tabari and Kenny. Toti Bese Leo Goitine. Lati your job, baby. Kaya Balala Koba. Tabari Akbara Kaibara. Tote Ogo Itine Remole. Lati O Nilo. Loru Ko Jesu. Or Ubi Sewakura.
So me di Bubo Fogo.
Then I'm going to close from there. Let me close from there.
So me di Bubo Fogo.
Let me close from there today.
So me di Bubo Fogo. Gege bi a your fair. Somebody di pupo fogo. Somebody di pupo fogo.
Use your gift and talent.
Somebody di pupo fogo. Gege bi ayo fe. Joseph ni le Jibiti.
Oh my God.
O so the prime minister.
Oh God.
Ojogu ile Goseni. Gege bi ayo fe. Somebody di pupo. Somebody di pupo fogo. Sabi di pupo fogo, sabi di pupo fogo. Gege bi ayon fe o, sabi di pupo fogo. Gege bi ayon fe. I want to feel serero.
Oh my God.
Koye kon sagbe ki won to je.
Oh my God.
Koye kon fi akisabora. Gege bi ayon fe. Sabi di pupo, sabi di pupo. Fogo, sabi di pupo fogo, sabi di pupo fogo. Oluwajo, sabi di pupo fogo, gege bi ayo fe.
I now pray for you from now on. Bible says, whatsoever we lay our hands upon shall prosper, shall prosper, shall prosper. Anything we lay our hands upon shall prosper, shall prosper. Hey! I pray for you. This little thing you are doing from today, you will prosper.
Amen.
Hey, I didn't hear you. Raise your two hands as a point of contact to heaven. Ayabala. Predosh. Ekrelosh. Predosh galor. What are we talking about here? Elevation. 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 elevation, elevation, elevation. As you have raised your hand to heaven, if there's any shackles, if there's any barrier, binding your hand together that is making good things to die at your hand, from today, your Father in heaven will break those shackles of your hand.
Amen.
Bible said, and my God, Philippians 4, shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory through, according to the capacity of Jesus. Oh, you want to know the capacity of Jesus? He said, they have given me a name that supersede, that overshadow, that is ahead every other name. If you like, follow the end of angel. Be called Angel Gabriel. That is your own cup of tea. If you like, call Angel Gabriel. You don't know what happened to Angel Gabriel? Go and check in the book of Daniel. Another angel has capacity to arrest Angel Gabriel. If you like, sit down with Angel Uriel. By the way, if you don't know, Uriel is not in the scripture. If you like, go and stand with Angel Raphael. By the way, Raphael is not in the scripture. Now, I now tell you today, stand with Christ. He said, they have given me a name that supersedes every other name. That's in the name of Jesus. Every knee. That is the capacity of my God. I now pray for you that you raise your hand as a point of contact today. Gbogbo eyin te nowo yin soke si orun gbogbo seke seke aye eleyi ti o je ko wo yin sase yori lato ni lo loruko Jesu orun pa Jesu. When I was coming today, the Lord began to interpret my brother to me. He said he has made the grace to transit in two generations. One grace passed through generation two from father, one generation. Ramile Kwaimo sang all songs. I don't know where he's getting his own money from on the stage, because all his songs, they are prophetical. All his songs, they are philosophical. All his songs, they are audible. So where is he finding the money? He doesn't have the maker beats. He doesn't have the charming beats. Then where is Ramile could see in all this? The reason is because God will call him to sit down, neither in trance, neither in dream. Sit down and write for the generation that is coming. I don't know what to say. Okay, oh yeah, now wait. My son, you know my son, Yenka, this is not my son. Wait. Don't go on. We said, God said that grace passed two generations. He said, I should be praying that grace should, when he enter into the third generation, they should not scatter it. I said, thank you, Jesus, because you used to reveal to me what is coming to happen. He said, I should pray that when this grace enter into the third generation, they will not scatter it. They will not say, we did not see this grace again. They will not say, it has entered into the archive, and we don't know where the archive is. And I pray for you from today.
nimbo ni mo le simile emi ko mo on bo bo si bi shora nimbo ni mo le simile emi ko mo on bo bo si bi shora omi to nse alabo lori eja ohun lo tun pada to se eja jino ile to fi rupe re mo ba araye ohun lo pada to fi yan soje ire aye ni mo so ko si mi fa ti laye Olorun ni mo gbe o aye sile aye sile o aye ni mo so aye ni mo so aye ni mo so o si bi farasi laye o o si bi farasi
Listen, listen. This song has been on ground almost 40 years. As of then, the wickedness has not manifested like now. The Lord said, Emelekwe must come. Write this. For this generation. This generation we are now. We don't want to stay under the mighty arm of God to oppress and slay anymore. We are in the east all the time. Fast food, fast car, fast food. Everything fast. Remelekwe must, God called him. Sit down. Right for this generation. He said the Father.
What's the Lord your power Bi Olorun ti tomole to laye Sibe sibe won fo koko se bi sadu Baba sho mi o ah Baba sho mi Elimi o ah Elimi sho mi One for sunshine, one to kini wulale, one for Sunday on la dauru. Gogo ero wani lati bia yon fesubu. Ki wole ya hacha ogo kuro lare. Ki wole gongo, olor alaye. Baba show me o, Baba show me, Eli me, oh, Christ show me. Farada, farada, oso tole, zike o ara. Farada. Farada o so tole tiki ara ojo le ni gba mi ran gogo re ko lokun ile farada 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 o so tole omo O so tole tiki o
I now pray for you today. By the reason of your louder amen, anywhere you might be, maybe you are at work, anywhere you might be, maybe you are on the flight, anywhere you might be, maybe you are in the kitchen, as long as you are connected to this platform, I pray for you today. Anywhere you have been suffering elevation in the past, from today, God. you up.
Amen.
Amen.
And then God called Emilequimus. Say, write for this generation. I have capacity to deliver them from all evils. And he wrote. He said, deliver us from all evils. Father Jesus, come.
Deliver us from evil. Father Jesus. Father Jesus, Father Jesus, amen, 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 oh. Deliver us from evil. Opa alade lo won juda nigba kon wono to gba dowo obirin morori opo lo nse awon to puro maye je aye lo se o afowo pa loju ibu ti pa ni o aye ni o
I now pray for you today. As we are glorifying God from this platform today, testimony will begin to happen in your life.
Amen.
Testimony, the enemy does not have control over. I'm going to bet your town. Hey! When the day of Mordecai came, it equals to the day of embarrassment. Embarrassment of the highest order to Haman. Mokbadra for you, Lord, Lord, who called you. Mokwa Hoton Retain, Chakuleni. Mokwa Hoton Retain, Jotte, my faith. Lord, who called you, one man ringing in the Yoko. Then we are now going to close. Mark in chapter 10, verse 27. Mark 10, 27. Jesus, he told me something. Mark 10, 27. He said, God, Eniyan, are you there? Read. With human being. And he said. And he said. Hey. And Jesus. I don't know those who are barren on this platform. The Lord here should tell you that you are not barren. It's only because you have not delivered a child. You are not barren. We now pray for this throne of grace, this platform of grace, unto the life of those that are trusting God for the fruit of their womb. We combine our faith together with your own faith, and we pray for you. You say amen, you type amen by faith today. I pray the Lord will open your womb for you.
Amen.
From today, the same authority that opened the womb of Hannah, the same authority that opened the womb of Rebecca, the same authority that opened the womb of Sarah, that same authority, it will open your womb.
Amen.
You will conceive.
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 Amen.
From this platform, we will hear your testimony.
Amen.
Those of you that you have been trusting God in the past, by the time we are going to come for November edition, December edition, January edition, you will have a testimony to share.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I now pray for those who are struggling with progress. You release album. Album did not go. Another person released nonsense. Nonsense, it blew. You do what others are doing. Nobody gets attention. You buy the product. The product damage in your shop. Hey! I pray for you today. If there's any barricade that the enemy has built against you, your name, spiritual barricade, gbogbo igbendeke inu emi ton ti gbe ni oju ona yin e wa le koja latoni lo loruko Jesu orun fo gbendeke na ogo ni foruko yin olorun wa. From today, you enter into your elevation.
Amen.
From today, you enter into your elevation.
Amen.
From today, you enter into your elevation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Next month, when you are going to come, you will have a bigger testimony to share.
Amen.
Finally, without Jesus, it's zero. Without Jesus, it is impossible. That is why it is impossible for you to stay connected to Jesus. Bible said when you separate yourself away from him, you can do nothing. I celebrate the grace upon his life. This year marks 18 years of our relationship. From the day one, you have always been combined about Christ. This thing will not do it. It's contrary to the scripture. I celebrate that grace. This thing is contrary to the scripture. Lekan will say, he's not doing. Every time, it is all about, what does the scripture say? I now pray for everybody here today. What will separate you from Christ will not come up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, give yourself, give your life unto Christ. Surrender your life to him today. Not only in this world is he capable to hold you, he's also capable to hold you in the world to come. I pray for you today. Those who are giving your life to Christ online, right now, the Lord take possession of you.
Amen.
You are welcome into Jesus' family.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And everybody on site here, ontiki shete olorun e oni dawole.
Amen.
Oh my God. Ontiki shete olorun e oni dawole.
Amen.
Oh, ise ti ki shete olorun esu oni ran yin. Mo gbadura loruko Jesu. 2021, hear the word of the Lord. The rest of this year, I pray for you, it will answer to you.
Amen.
It will deliver result to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Next month is going to be a 20-year series. We are going to be blasting high. 20 years. 20 years of God's grace. 20 years of God's leading. 20 years of God's sustenance. I pray that next month it shall be colorful.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
I think it should be more than that. A round of applause for that man of God, fully loaded with grace and the anointing of God. Thank you, my pastor. God bless you. But we have to. Quickly, we are rounding up. And I believe you have been blessed by now. If you are blessed, say amen.
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 Now, we are going to render the covenant song as usual. Ama da oruko isu yi sinu orin yen. Wa ma bere ohun to fe lowo Olorun ninu osu yi bi Oluwa tin be ti emi re sin be iyanu ma wonu aye re lo.
Amen.
Now ba shi la masare shi laarin seju meji, and I want to quickly remind you, our viewers and our fans all over the world, that we'll be celebrating the 20 years remembrance of our patriarch father, Dr. Remilekun Imons, in the city of Ikeja, in Lagos, November the 7th, 2021. It's going to be wonderful. Oh God, you are invited. You are all invited. It's going to be wonderful. November 7th, 2021, in the city of Ikeja. More updates will be coming and you'll be receiving them. I pray for you. Before we come back in the month of November, you will have received multiple testimonies.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to appreciate everybody that has supported us and they are still supporting us all over. A lot of them don't even want their names to be mentioned. They are behind the scenes supporting us. I pray for you all. Heaven will keep opening for you.
Amen.
Thank you. God bless you. One, two, go. Emma Miki on to Bacabo.
Ma ba olorun so on to fe ninu osu October yi. Ba se ma nse lojoju ni. October osu igbeka. Emma Miki on to Bacabo. Koni bere mi, o ma bere mo. Koni bere mi, o ma bere mo. Ma ba Olorun so, ohun gbogbo to fe ninu osu October yi. Iserere ko ma te lowo. Anu se ni kankan o le salaye. Ko ba le ise ati ona re. October, oh, show you better. Never make you October come. Never make you October come. Never make you October come. Oni bere mi, koma bere mo. Oh, oni bere mi, koma bere mo. Oku igba meji ta ma ko tori akoko wa. Oni bere mi ko ma gogo bo. Oh. Oni bere mi ko ma gogo bo. Soro ase sinu October. Soro ase sori osu yi. O le mu ogo jade fun. Ever make you to back up. October, what should we do? Ever make you to back up. What is it? 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 If I want your tokuri, ever make you October come, ever make you October come. October, on shui shere remi, ever make you October come. Boni bere me, koma bere me. Boni bere me, koma bere me.
Thank you, Jesus. October, gbogbo odun ninu ebi ti wa osu ire ni. Because this is the month of my lovely daughter, Oluwa jo mi loju, Remele Kwemos. Oluwa jo mi loju gidi gan gan. And the month of our smiling, talking drummer, Alujo. And that of our sonorous singer, the last one, Emisi, and in bed the poor Lushui. In the Kibito, I go away and soak it. You know what in bed, see a mere simbe, book walk on to Dara Pomo program in Lurui, Luru called Jesu, a rito of him, we all know what lie. A ring and one year alone. Book walk by ye. Lo ma yin Olorun logo nitori tire. Gbogbo eda to nowo iran lowo si platform yi. Si ministry yi Remele Kwemos International Gospel Ministry. Gbogbo awon okunrin obirin won wa ni Nigeria won o si ni Nigeria won wa ni ilu Oyinbo. Ohun ko ohun ti won se to mu irere tesiwaju loruko Jesu orun yin ko ni tipa. Ninu awon eniyan to ma sere laye orun fi oruko yin sakoko. Hello, my big bow. Let us share the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, goodness and mercy and follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven powerful hallelujah. One to go.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you. See you in the month of November.